Good afternoon, everybody. Commissioner of Police, Chauhan, Additional Commissioner, Shri N. Yadaiah, Registrar JNTU, he's left already. Manoj Kumar, Deputy Secretary UGC, and Shri Naik, Dean DU. All the member, all the principals and managements of college and the anti-ragging committee who are here, and police officers. When we thought of having this meeting, the anti-ragging meeting, there were various reasons for holding the meeting, but one thing which did not occur to me is that this would be a very nice opportunity to get nostalgic. So we have everybody in the dais and outside, especially in the ones in the uniform, who are all nostalgic about their days when they were being ragged or they indulged in ragging. So takes me back to my day, the first day when it started with the, in the, we had this university special, so you took a university special bus to reach the college. So the ragging started from the university special bus and then in the college, although it was a girls' institute, but we believe in equality, so we should not go be far behind any of us. So, you know, this has made us nostalgic, so this is an added icing on the cake for having this meeting besides the other factors. Ragging, as most of us know, was supposed to be a process of familiarizing with the newly new generation which was entering into the colleges, and it was the process in which there was you know, harmless banter and an ice breaking kind of what management talks about, ice breaking. This is what it was supposed to be at times. But this innocent thing has at times turned into a means or a process of ill treatment, and which results in certain serious incidents. Now, all the measures which are required to be taken have already been spelled out by the from the UGC member, and I'm sure all of you have those committees. There isn't probably any college in Hyderabad who doesn't have an anti-ragging committee or the anti-ragging squads who do not have it in the prospectus that ragging will not be tolerated, the undertaking being taken by parents and all. This is something I'm sure everybody across the board is doing. I just wanted to check with you, Mr. Manoj. I think this anti-ragging committee needs to have civilian as well as police officers also on board. But probably this is one thing which is lacking. I'm not sure if the DCPs are aware. Do we have our police SHO or the SI sector in the anti-ragging committee? All colleges have. If there are certain ones who are nodding that we don't have, I would please urge you to please ensure that the local police station, somebody is a part of your anti-ragging committee. Your anti-ragging squad is more of an individual unit, your college thing, but the anti-ragging committee needs to have. So from both my, I'll request the DCPs as well to get in touch with the institutes and the other institutes, because the purpose of the anti-ragging committee is a little more broad-based, where you need to have all stakeholders on board, the purpose being that if anything happens, one is anyway initial awareness, and second is that if something happens, you have all stakeholders there to take care of whatever has to be done. So it would be advisable to, you know, have all the stakeholders involved in your committee. So your committees need to be more broad-based where they are not. So one request is to please do that. Now, as has been pointed out, we have been, because of all the proactive work which the various anti-ragging committees and with the college managements have done, we have had a largely incident-free thing in the last couple of years. Although in the Hyderabad region, in last year also two cases were reported. But Hyderabad city, the last cases were reported in 2015. Now, although it is very impressive and very nice for us that we are incident-free, one thing which results in this is that at times, because of something which has been implemented over the years, it enters into kind of a routine thing. So we become a little complacent about the entire issue because nothing is happening. So this becomes very routine every year. This has to be done. So it's like it's done in a very mechanical way. So I would urge you to realize that each batch or each academic session and each group of people who come to you are a different set of individuals. Each of them come with a different kind of challenges. You are more aware than me. And the students come from different socio-economic backgrounds. Their sensitivities differ a lot. So as DCP East Ramesh was talking about, that maybe earlier we were more battle-hardened, in police language we would say, to deal with certain things. Now, because of the kind of protective environment in which our children grow up, they are very sensitive to certain things. And it is very difficult for any of us to realize the psychology of any other person. So a small measure of fun by that ragging, which may be tolerated by one person, may result in an extreme reaction in another person. So the problem is that we cannot judge beforehand whether X thing would result in reaction it would generate in the person. So it is very necessary, as we are saying, to have a zero tolerance. The other factor which a number of us spoke about is the hesitation of reporting. Also the hesitation, or at times not realizing the importance or the seriousness of the issue. So when there are small things being happening, we tend to ignore them. Not because we really want to, you know, that we don't want to report, but probably we want to ignore them, thinking that these are something which happen normally and something serious to be done. Now we need to remember that these are things which at times can then boomerang and may result in an incident. We have to realize that a single incident would mar whatever we have been doing over the period of last few years, or whatever the college has taken action. And as I said, we cannot judge the reaction of the person. Therefore, it is very essential that the measures which you are taking, those measures have to be taken not in a routine manner, but with the same seriousness as they were in the first year when they were implemented. That needs to be done. We all know that there are different places where ragging happens, mostly in common areas, the playgrounds, the canteens, the hostels, the transport, and even maybe outside the institute, where there are areas or residential areas where large number of students stay. So we should not overlook these areas just because something happens to be out of our campus. The responsibility lies with all of us. CCTVs, I believe that most of the institutes now have CCTVs. Please ensure that these CCTVs, one, are in the areas which are prone. I mean, I can have 100 CCTVs, but if it is not in the area where it is required, or if it doesn't have where it covers in the dark, because for example, in the hostels and other places, number of time, or the playgrounds, it happens in the night time rather than happening in the day. And if at that moment we say that the CCTV doesn't have the night viewing thing, or doesn't capture, or it is not clear, the purpose is lost. So you need to please relook at that. The importance of CCTV is known to all of us. In Hyderabad city, we have more than 2 lakh CCTVs, and it has brought down crime by almost 40% in the city. So by that virtue, you can realize the importance of having and how much deterrence a camera can have. So it is essential that we promote it and ensure that proper each and every nook and corner is covered. When we talk about